Why y'all all in my face? Dang, fix this. Okay, so back with more questions. Okay, so last thing. Who's your mama, Vina? That's some ball. Wait, I need to fix myself because I feel like you guys can't see my beautiful designer shirt. Let me fix myself. Let me fix myself. So, let me back up. Sorry, guys. I'm like, no, good. But, sorry, y'all. But, yeah, so... question. Okay, last question was about the guy, the flirt. Don't set yourself up for failure. Because, if the guy flirts, he's always gonna flirt. Like, you can't make a guy stop doing anything, he don't wanna do. You can't, no matter what you do. I don't care how good the yuhu is. I don't care if you got goddamn Jesus Christ down there. He's still gonna do what he wanna do. So I say, don't even set yourself up for that. Just be like, okay, whatever. Nothing be your boo thing, girl. Ain't nothing wrong with being a boo thing. And the wrong one being your boo thing. I say you don't want to get hurt. So, I don't know. I mean, if you want to keep doing it, then you can go ahead and do it. But I say no, girl. And you said... what else did you say? Wait. You said... you know, you get nervous around guys. I do too. So, you know what? I just let them talk to me. And if, just play hard to get. Because then, if you play hard to get, then the guy is going to keep talking to you. You don't have to say anything. That's what I do. If people come to me and be like, oh, how you doing? I'm like, who he talking to? Who you talking to? Like, oh, how you doing? Oh, what's your name? I'm like, oh, you don't want to talk? Anyway, girl, yeah, because... And then, you know, he talks to me and he play hard to get. And then next thing you know, I'm like, oh, okay, what's your number? And give me his number. And then I text him if I want to. I walk away, I'm like, girl, you're so cute. Ooh, girl, let me, hey, I'm a ooh you tonight. So you can see my face. He looking good. So sometimes it's play hard to get. Because I get nervous too in front of guys. I do. I'm telling you, every time, I mean, when I talk to Princeton and them, I'm like, yeah, when Prodigy come, my body gets stuck. I go. Like, I'm like this the whole time he talks to me. Like, I'm stuck. Like, I can't move. And then I'm like. Like, I understand where you're coming from. Because I'm like that. Even with any guy. Especially if I like them. I'm just like. Like, I freeze up. Like, I don't know what to do. But just relax. Hey, I'm telling you, if you get them that attitude, like, you know what you're doing and you're calm, all they're going to do is talk to you. Because they feel like, oh, look at her attitude. Look, she's playing hard to get. I'm about to get this. And they're going to talk your ear off. And then you can just stop them. Boop, 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 boop. And then you keep moving. But if you want to keep talking to them, then you go ahead. And just stay calm. And remember, there's nothing dumb you can actually say. It's just... there's nothing dumb. Every question is a question for a reason. Remember that. Just choose what you want to say. Say it in your head first. Like, oh, what should I say? Just, like, talk to yourself. When he's talking, you talk to yourself. Okay, he's talking to me right now. Okay, what should I say? Okay, wait. Okay. And, like, I do that, too. I do it all the time in project. Anytime, every time they're in project talk, I be in my head like, oh, shit. What am I going to say? Oh. Yeah, God, what am I gonna say? Okay, he's not talking anymore. Yeah, I remember that. You moron. Why would you say that? Great, you are so stupid. Like, I do the same thing too, but you never know what the guy feels. You might think it's stupid. Oh my God, why would I say that? He might be like, yo, I really like her. You know, so you never know. And I guess one thing I hate about us females, we overanalyze things, and I hate that. I hate that. So just be cool, breathe. And take calm. But I say about the flirt, if you really like him, then be your boo thing before he's your boyfriend. Just talk to him. Get to feel him out. Because if he's still doing that, oh, yeah, yeah. And then he's talking to C, CeCe, Alex, and Vanessa, no, then leave him alone. Boop, 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 boop. Tell him bye, 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 okay? What's your opinion on Emily dating someone 2 years younger than them? Yeah. If they feel like the chemistry is there and you're younger than them, let me tell you something. You can help who you fall in love with. You can never help who you fall in love with. So don't ever try to fight it. And if a prodigy happens to fall in love with me and I'm older than him, I'm going to be like, fuck. I don't know what I'm going to say. But I'm going to be like, oh, okay. You know, maybe, I don't know who your boo thing is because you didn't tell me who's your man's. But if your man's Princeton, most likely all of you guys love Princeton anyway. I think it's that damn puff. But if you like Princeton, and Princeton, how old is you, Princeton? I don't even know how old Princeton is. I gave up on his age. I'm sorry. I quit. I retire. I gave up on his age. But if he's, Princeton, I don't know. Okay, if you're 2 years younger, then you're not even that young. Like, he's not even that old. And it's always cute like that. You know, the guy is 2 years older than you, 2 years younger. It's cute. So I think they would definitely do it, especially if the chemistry's there. Girl, you good. You good. Chill out. Chill out. Sit back. You're to Arizona. You good, girl. You good. Hi, honey. Hi. Wait, my music stopped playing. Whoa. Where they do that at? Hold on, y'all. I got this music on. Her question was, come on, no. Oh, hi, honey, hi. If Patrick from Audio, that's what it means, came up to you right now. Right now? Looking like this? Wait, why you gotta come right now? I'm not ready yet. He came up to you right now and said he wants to marry you. What would you say? What would you do? How would you react? What would I say? What would I do? How would I react? I'll be like, what'd you say? I'll be like, huh? What'd you say? Like, I wouldn't believe it. Like, my head would start hurting. Like, it's hurting right now. My head hurts, guys. I wouldn't know what to say. I'd be like, huh? I would cry a lot. I would have to do the worm. I would have to drop down and do the worm, you guys, because I'd be freaking out. Girl. Don't get me started in here. I will be freaking out. Like, honestly. I will be like, oh my God, are you serious? I will keep asking them, like, are you serious? But how serious are you? Are you really serious or are you playing with me? Like, how serious are you? Like, I need to know how serious he is. But, girl, listen. Listen. A man's come to me talking about something. He want to marry me. I'm going to be done. Like, I'm going to be done. I'm going to be like, wow, are you serious? I would say yes. I think I will. But you know what? I don't know. I think I will say yes. But
I'll have to on Patrick. On Patrick.
But yeah, that's what happened if Patrick would ask me. I would think I would say yeah if anything. Okay, she said, P.S., I love your hair. Girl, you know I be fly. Thank you. But she said that her cousin says that her and Rob make a cute couple. Aww. And she said she's going to meet and greet, but she doesn't know what to say to him. I'm telling you guys, the best way at the meet and greet is to just, like, seriously, write a letter, because I'm telling you, you guys don't have enough time to have a full-blown conversation. You go, you get your poster, your CD, they sign it, hey, and then you're gone. That's it. So I would say write something or quickly say what you have to say. Be like, you know, Rock, I love you. You know, you're my favorite MV boy. You know, I stay up and think about you. You know, I stay hate minus all the time. You know, tell him how you feel. You guys got to use the opportunity, those little moments, to tell them how you feel. If you feel like you can't tell them face to face, write a letter, girl. What you think they did back in the 1900s? They wrote letters. They ain't keep you up on the phone. Hey, no, man. They wrote letters. They got on their horses and they galloped over there and they said it to their face. Or they wrote letters. Y'all better get your life. I say you use that moment. All of you guys. If you have a meet and greet, you, or even if you see him, don't ask him how you hear, why you hear like, no. Tell them how you feel. Tell them. Use that. Because they all got that little soft spot right there. They all got that little soft spot. So if you tell them like, love you, yo. Thank you. Understand you. And they all in my cats after y'all, yo. Swear, yo. Like, tell them. And then they're like, wow, like, I did that. And that's how they're gonna come over and be like, oh. Let me tell you, at Kmart, right? Promise them at Kmart, right?
You're getting more followers.
Oh, yay. Okay, at Kmart, right? This girl, she was like, like, she took it down. She just fell right to the floor. It was set right in front of them. Just set right there in front of the table crying. And Prodigy and Princeton got up like, she's sitting on the floor crying? And she's talking to, I think she's talking to Prodigy because Prodigy got up first. I think so. And she said, I love you. Like, you don't understand what you do to me. I love you. Like, I seriously love you. And it's not, you know, a fatuation. I love you, you know. And Prodigy was like, wow. Like, he got up. No, before he got up, Princeton got up, walked around the table, and sat on the floor right in front of her, in the Indian style, sitting right in front of her, and just held her hand. And then Prodigy walked over, and he hugged her, he just held her and embraced her, and she just cried, and he was like, thank you, like, I'm telling you, they have a sensitive spot for our emotions. Tell them how you feel. You will get extra time with them. 9 out of 10 times, you will get extra time with them. That girl had an extra 5 minutes at a doggone freaking, what is it, meet and greet. You know, when you do stuff like that and they see how impactful, I'm not saying don't go over there, get your eye dropped, and you're like, oh yeah, I'm gonna cry today. No, don't do that. Hey, don't do that. Don't do it. Now let it be real. I'm telling you, let them see how they affect you. Let them see that, okay? Because when I cried, I didn't go all crazy. I just sat there. I just sat back and I just, like, I cried. Prodigy and Preston looked at me like, oh, honey, come on, get your emotional. And, you know, he came over to me and was like, are you okay? What's wrong? I was just like, Prodigy, don't even worry about it. You know, don't worry about it. I was just like, I love you guys. That's it. I love you guys. And that's it. He left. And I was getting ready to leave and he came back for me. And I was just like, they have a soft spot for our emotions. They feel what we feel. So I'm trying to tell you guys, when you have moments like that, talk to them. Talk. Open your mouth. If you feel like you can't talk, write a letter. Especially if it's for Princeton. Princeton reads. That little boy nosy. He nosy. Even if it's not for you, he's gonna lean over the table like, hey, what was that? Get your nosy. Get out of here, nosy. Like, he's gonna read your letter. You're gonna give him that paper. He's gonna be like, oh, yeah. Oh. And then next time, he's like, oh, you was the girl that gave me that letter that one time. We got that one place. Remember that one day? It was you. Like, and then next thing you know, y'all talking. You're having a football conversation. You never know. Try it. Do it, okay? Please, you guys. I want y'all to do that. If y'all can do anything for me, tell and be the person you mad and love, your mans. Tell them how you feel. Please, if you can do anything. I'm mad I don't got no dog on Arizona left. I'm pissed. Oh, and then you never want to write them a letter. I mean, like, a story. Don't write them letters. I mean, stories. Don't do that. Do you think Prince and Lonely Girl has a thing for each other? Why? Is it because do I think the OMG girls and MB boys have anything between each other? I think probably it did, but it fell apart really quickly. I don't see them actually doing anything. Honestly. OMG girls is not my cup of Arizona.